Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to group and filter items in the Angular AutoComplete component. Look at this example. You can see the AutoComplete component displaying different vegetable names. These vegetables are grouped under different categories like leafy and salad, beans, and bulb and stem. You can apply different filter types to filter data items in the AutoComplete component. I will now show you how to group and filter autocomplete items using my Getting Started application. Let me open my existing Angular application, where I have added the Angular AutoComplete component with basic properties. Here, I have bound vegetable names to the data source and mapped the appropriate data source field to the fields property of the AutoComplete component. I have set the placeholder property value to select a vegetable. Follow the link provided in the card and video description below to learn the basics of adding an Angular AutoComplete to an app. Now, I will run this example using the command ng-serve. You can see the AutoComplete component showing vegetable names. Next, let me show you the steps to group the AutoComplete items. I open the app component TS file first. Here, I need to define one more field, category, with appropriate values on each object of the existing data source. Then, I will map this new category field name to the group by option within the fields property of the AutoComplete component. Make sure that the local data and data fields variables are already assigned to the data source and fields properties. Now, when you look at the component, the data items are grouped under the categories leafy and salad, bulb and stem, and beans. Here, by default, the data items are filtered based on the characters typed in the search box and starts with filter type applied to AutoComplete. To filter data based on ends with or contains filter types, use filter type property. First, I will demonstrate filtering the items based on their end characters. I define a string variable AutoComplete filter type and set its value to ends with. Then, I assign this string variable to the filter type property. When I type some characters here, you can see the pop-up showing vegetable names that end with my typed-in characters. Similarly, you can also apply contains filter type to filter data items that contain your typed-in characters at any position. Notice here, by default, the casing of the typed-in characters is ignored during the filtering action on AutoComplete, but for the characters to have the same casing, set the ignore case property to false. Now, you can see that when I start to type some uppercase characters, the AutoComplete displays no records due to the casing mismatch. Notice here, three data items are shown in the suggestion pop-up when G character is typed. If I want to specify the filter suggestion item count of the AutoComplete, then I can use suggestion count property. Here, I have planned to display two data items in the suggestion pop-up, so let me define suggestion count property and set its value as 2. So here, you can see when I type in the characters, the AutoComplete control displays two data items in the suggestion pop-up that matches the typed-in characters. By default, the search action is performed by typing single character in the AutoComplete component. Suppose I want to perform the search action after typing three characters, then I define min-length property and set its value as 3. See the output page now, the searching action is performed only after typing three characters. Finally, let me show you how to filter with diacritic characters in the text. Let me define a string array and add the items with some diacritic characters in it. Then, I assign this string array to the data source property. Since I have assigned the array of strings with diacritic characters directly to the AutoComplete data source, I remove the fields property and change the placeholder value to select a value. I want to filter the data items using their starting characters and ignore the casing, so I remove the filter type and ignore case properties. Along with this, I will remove suggestion count and min length properties to show all the data items based on typed in characters and perform search action by typing single character. Finally, I set the ignore accent property to true to ignore the diacritic characters or accents when filtering. Now, when you look at this AutoComplete component, you can see the pop-up displaying filtered data items that include diacritic characters. In this video, we have seen how to group and filter items in the Angular AutoComplete component. We looked at the supported filter types, how to apply those filters, and how to include diacritic characters while filtering. If you would like to see an interactive working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.